Live from Hashtag Studios, this is Strive Center.
Hello, you're watching Strive Center. I'm Colt Paulson.
And I'm Andrea Neal. It's been a crazy week in high school sports.
Cozad and BDS football have both been undefeated this year, 7-0.
And don't forget about volleyball. BDS had a great game, which we have highlights from, and an interview with the coach.
But first, let's take it off to Jaden with Cozad football.
Thanks, Colt. Now to the highlights. After the quarterback tosses it to the running back, Kearney Catholic shows us exactly how not to tackle and gives up a touchdown. The Cozad quarterback airs it out to his wide receiver, who takes it in for the 70-yard score. I have to add that the bench loves it. After the handoff, the running back basically walks through a giant hole in the Kearney Catholic defense for yet another Cozad touchdown. After a quick jersey change by both teams, Kearney Catholic's punter boots one downfield, only for the Haymakers' return man to Johnny Manziel it down the sideline, embarrassing in particular number 38, who has no idea what he's doing. I've been to a lot of good high school football games this year, and this was not one of them, as Cozad takes home the blowout win over Kearney Catholic. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Jaden. That was a very exciting game. I was there, and it was a huge nail-biter.
Oh, yeah. Very crazy. And good win for Cozad.
Yes.
And now, Caleb with BDS football.
Thanks, Andrea. Eagles quarterback Mike Flacco hands it off to Smoochie Walls for a gain of 45. Tonight, he has had 20 carries for 206 yards. Flacco pitches it to Smoochie for a gain of 20. Huskies need one to wrap up, but they don't want a chance in this game. Second and third, the Huskies line up in the shotgun formation. Jason Morales hands it off to Colton Morris for a rush of 18 yards. Colton has had 16 carries for 173 yards. Eagles quarterback drops in the pocket, looks to the right, and meets with number 66 in the end zone. Eagles touchdown. It's handed off to Colt Morris for the conversion, and it's good. Eagles quarterback checks deep but has no one open, so he looks to Smoochie and he is stopped at 15. Eagles running back looking for the touchdown, 5 yards to go, but the ball is ripped from running while he's down with defensive cover. Huskies line up 10 yards from the end zone. It's handed off to Colt Morris, who blows over on the fourth floor touchdown. What a run. Eagles go home with a win, 40 points to the Huskies, 26. Back to Andrea and Colt.
Wow, what a name, Smoochie. I've never heard that one before. But it sounded like a good game.
And Colton Morris was also doing very well.
Yes. Now we're going to take it off to Claire with BBS Volleyball.
Thanks, Colt. Starting off the game, the serve's up, received by Smith. Keely Reiner up for the kill, and it goes right through the block. Don Beans up to serve, and it's over and in. Anderson up for the hit, and it is out. Serves up, received by Williams. Robertson up for a back row attack, and is hit out of bounds by Walters for Fairbury. Serves up, received by Lee. Mayers up for the hit, bam, right through the block. Hares up to serve. The serve is dug by Wilson and is hit out of bounds by Klein. Serves up, received by James. Back row attack by Reeves, hit out by Fairbury, and another win for Thayer. Back to you, Colt.
Sounds like Don.
Thank you, Claire.
Sounds like Dawn Beans is having a really great season.
Yes, she has the legs of a stallion. That is the definition of an athlete.
Oh, yeah. And now, an studio interview with Cody, with the BDS volleyball coach.
I am here with the volleyball coach from Bruning-Davenport Shickley, Shauna Garland. Coach, your volleyball team has always had a good reputation. What were your expectations at the start of the season?
Well, they were pretty high because we were returning quite a few seniors as well as players with experience.
Along with your expectations, what is your main goal as a team?
Well, we want to try to take every game one at a time, but of course we have in the back of our minds that we were fourth at state a couple years ago and we'd like to exceed that.
Do you have any up-and-comers on the team?
We do. We have two sophomores that see a lot of playing time, as well as there's some bright spots in our junior high as well.
Conference just started up. Where do you think your team stands? What are your chances of coming out on top?
If we play the way we've been playing, we should do pretty well. But considering the Crossroads Conference is always a tough conference, I'm sure we'll run into some tough games along the way.
There you have it. We appreciate you taking your time to visit with us, Coach, and good luck on the rest of the season.
And now, an interview with Coach Cargill of Cozad. Take it away, Allison.
Thank you, Andrea. Hi, Coach. So Cozad has had a
How are you doing, Allison?
I'm good. So Cozad has had a great season being undefeated, and they're playing in district playoffs next Thursday. What do you expect from your team?
Well, we expect them to come out and play a great game, you know. I'm pretty excited about hosting the home game, obviously. And kids have worked hard all year to have that opportunity, so we're looking forward to it.
Okay, good. What special skills or qualities does your team possess that has gotten them so far this season?
Well, obviously we've got some good players, but kids have bought into, you know, the things we're doing this year, and especially on the defensive side of the ball, they're starting to get an understanding of what it takes to, you know, get the job done. And they've worked exceptionally hard over the summer, you know, to get themselves in shape to have success at this point. So we're pretty proud of them.
Okay, and what do you think the key is to having so many wins as you have had in one season?
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you there, Allison. Could you repeat that, please?
What do you think the key is to so many wins in one season?
Well, I don't think there's any big secret, but obviously you have to be disciplined and you got to work hard. You got to have some talented kids, and you know, I've always been a believer that you make your own luck, and our kids have worked very hard to make their own luck. So, you know, they've done a great job, and if you take care of business and do what you can, then things go your way.
And your team has been the victim of so many injuries this season. Have any of them affected the way your team plays or even team morale?
No, actually, you know, we've been pretty fortunate injury-wise, except for JR at the beginning of the year. You know, we've been very healthy to this point of game eight. So, you know, the one thing that we were able to do, we did have some guys who were able to step up and fill JR's spot. You know, obviously we'd like to have him around, but since that's not the case, we've been very pleased with the guys who stepped in and took care of business there. So we hope that our health continues to stay good, and we are able to make a nice playoff run, hopefully.
Okay, thank you, and good luck to you at district playoffs. And we're going to hand it back over to Andrea and Colt in the studio.
Thank you.
What a great interview.
Such a great man.
Yes.
Now for the top 10 in sports this week.
Number 10, straight hit but thrown out at first.
Number 9, look at that spike.
Number 8, an amazing pass, but he did not get a touchdown.
Number 7, gets tackled, but scores a touchdown anyway. Ooh, get it!
Number 6, that's the way, she spikes it.
Number 5, touchdown!
Number 4, great catch, but he's gonna feel that one in the morning. Ooh, kill him.
Number three, score a game, but with a little pain.
Number 2, having a Jesus moment on water can help you score a touchdown.
And number one, bad camera work, but you can still see that wonderful home run.
Thanks for watching Strive Center tonight. I'm Cole Paulson.
And I'm Andrea Neal. Stay classy.
Good night.